This is your High Desert Sports Report, the Victor Valley's only weekly action highlights sports program, covering our area's schools, teams, athletes, and sporting events. Hesperia Christians softball ladies are CIF champions. The Lady Patriots defeated Harupa Valley 8-7 to win the CIF Division 8 title game. Freshman Sophie Anderson scampered home on a wild pitch to score the game-winning run in the thrilling come-from-behind bottom-of-the-seventh inning rally that earned Hesperia Christian the first CIF softball championship in school history. Harupa Valley had gone ahead 7-6 in the top of the seventh. Sophomore Eden Skinner led off the bottom of the seventh with a single and came around to score the tying run. Eden Skinner went 3-for-4, scored 2 runs, and stole 2 bases to lead Lady Patriots hitters in the title game. Fellow sophomore Haley Hoffman went 2-for-3, drove in a run, and scored a run in the title game. Sophomore Elise Vanderwetty also had a multiple hit game with 2 hits and 2 runs scored. Macy Pierakowski earned the win. The senior struck out 5. Only 2 of Harupa Valley's 7 runs were earned runs. Coach April Skinner's Lady Patriots play next in the state regionals tournament, which begins May 28th.
Congratulations on your first win. Your High Desert Sports Report is brought to you by Down Home Grill in Victorville on the corner of Bear Valley Road and Ridgecrest Road. Bid fast and last, sold on supporting High Desert Sports. The Bradco Companies, supporting all of the teams and sports programs throughout the Mojave River Valley. Iwanzak Law Firm, trial lawyers for serious problems. Valu Quality Truck Body, We Got 'Em Tees, your headquarters for custom screen printing and mastercraft embroidery design. And by the Holiday Inn in Victorville, supporting the teams, schools, and sports programs throughout the Victor Valley. Reggie Lawson leads 2015 Victor Valley Jackrabbits to Desert Sky League Championship. On this date, years past, Apple Valley tangles with AAE in the 2017 opening round of CIF. Victor Valley's Brett Bowers powers and pitches. The Jackrabbits passed Apple Valley in 2018 CIF playoffs. We lead off this series of flashbacks with the 2015 regular season showdown for the Desert Sky League title.
The Victor Valley Jackrabbits are champions of the Desert Sky League. Reggie Lawson homers and closes it out on the mound, leading Victor Valley past rival Silverado 7-4.
It's a great feeling to be the rival. They're a good team, but we came out here and played rubber ball and did what we had to do, and now it's on to the playoffs.
Nando Ruiz shuts out the home team Hawks through 5. The junior enters the game with a 2.22 earned run average with 31 strikeouts in 41 innings. The Jackrabbits add 3 more in the 4th, 2 on Reggie Lawson's long home run over the left field fence. Mike Nolan scores ahead of Lawson. The 6-2 junior Lawson enters the game with a team-high 471 batting average and 23 runs driven in. Now he has 25, and he's not done for the day in that department. In the 6th, the Jackrabbits strike again. Reggie Lawson drives in Seth Escamilla with the base hit to left. Second hit on the day for Lawson, 3rd RBI. It's 6-0. One might guess the Rabbits have this one in the bag. Big lead, Nando Ruiz, clear sailing. The Hawks say, guess again. 2 on, nobody out, bottom 6. Team RBI leader Nathan Barcina drives in 2. Barcina all the way to 3rd as the ball is misplayed. Rabbits lead narrowed to 4. It's 6-2. Wyatt Powell, second hit of the game. Nathan Barcina scores 6-3. Silverado adds 1 more on a fielder's choice, and we go to the 7th, 6-4 Jackrabbits. Andy Pasquale leads off the seventh. Fourth home run of the year for the 6'1", 205-pound Bubba Pasquale, drawing the senior catcher even with Reggie Lawson in home runs and going a long way in draining the momentum away from the home team Hawks after their four-run sixth. On comes Reggie Lawson to close. Lawson goes 0-2 on Brandon Jimenez before Jimenez works a full count and then lifts the base hit down the left field line, a stand-up double. Lawson fields the comebacker for the second out, Victor Valle, one out away from the league championship. The third out comes when freshman second baseman Abdiel Mejia squeezes the pop-up and the celebration begins. How sweet it is, and even sweeter when the title is clinched against your crosstown rival?
I think it's always sweeter to beat your rival, and it's such a key point in our season. It just feels great.
The fourth-ranked Apple Valley Sun Devils fully capitalize on AAE defensive lapses to overtake the Knights and take a 9-1 opening round win in the CIF Division 5 playoffs. Apple Valley gets a superb performance from Tanner Fuller, who struck out 12 in going the distance. His approach was straightforward.
They were a good team, and it was tough to beat them.
The home team Knights draw first blood when leading hitter Ryan Pendleber stays back on the curveball and drives it hard through the right side of the Sun Devils infield. Ben Morrison scores from second. Morrison had doubled off the fence in left field for AAE's first hit, team-high 19th run driven in on the season for Ryan Pendleber, who leads all hitters on the field this day. He sports a .571 batting average. Bases loaded, one out, top of the order, up for the Sun Devils. Elian Ortega's base hit to left drives in William Villarino, and the visitors have tied the score at one. First of two base hits on the day for the Sun Devils leadoff hitter and center fielder. Logan Valencia drives in the go-ahead run with the base hit to left. Jacob Escobar scoring to make it 2-1 Apple Valley. By the time it is all said and done, only two of Apple Valley's 9 runs on the day will be of the earned run variety. Tanner Fuller completes his day's work, cutting down the final hitter he faces, having succeeded in shutting out the Knights after AAE's unearned run in the first. AAE's season ends with a record of 18-3. Apple Valley heads into round 2 of the CIF playoffs. The Victor Valley Jackrabbits eliminate Apple Valley in the opening round CIF Division 4 playoffs, breaking open a 1-1 extra inning deadlock with a 4-run outburst in the ninth. Brett Bowers belts a 2-run home run in the ninth to fuel the 5-3 triumph and power the Jackrabbits past the Sun Devils in a matchup between Desert Sky League and Mojave River League runners-up. Jackrabbits coach Juan Mejias has called on Brett Bowers to make the start. The 6'1", 195-pound junior had been sidelined the last two regular season games, wins against Barstow. Brett Bowers, 6-0 coming in, with a .32 earned run average, lowest among Desert Sky League pitchers. These Cross Valley rivals quite evenly matched. Apple Valley ranked 12th in CIF Division 4. The Jackrabbits ranked 43rd. It's warm and very windy. A controversial call contributes to Apple Valley's offensive efforts in the fourth. Joey Vera has walked. Drew Pollard lines the shot to third baseman Dylan Rivera, who throws to first for the double play. But the umpires confer and rule the catch was short-hopped, allowing Joy Vera to remain at second. Christian Hill's bunt is fielded by Brett Bowers, whose throw sails over the head of first baseman Aaron Feakin, enabling Joy Vera to score from second.
Thus, Apple Valley's first run is not only unearned, but the Sun Devils are beneficiaries of the controversial ruling that had enabled Joy Vera to remain at second. At the end of four, the score is tied at one. This is Mikey Prieto, not only Victor Valley's leading hitter, but the top hitter in the Desert Sky League, a 474 batting average coming in. Two outs, speedy Gavin Hendricks on first. Mikey Prieto drills it deep to the fence in right center field. Gavin Hendricks running with two outs, scoring easily from first. First Rabbits run scored since the second. Team high 18th run driven in on the year for Mikey Prieto. It's Victor Valley on top, 2-1, and the Jackrabbits are far from done. Ramon Alcantar sends Mikey Prieto across with another drive deep to center field. Victor Valley's lead is 2-3-1. Brett Bowers seals the deal, stepping into the pitch and sending it high, deep, up, over and out. Third home run of the season for Brett Bowers, and unbeknownst at the moment, runs the Rabbits will wind up needing to escape Apple Valley with the victory. Devils enter the playoffs winners of 20 games, and they are not going to go down without a fight to the finish. Dallas Williams aboard. The hard hit ball, the left misread. Ramon Alcantar gets out number one on the called third strike to Jesus Diaz, who comes off the bench and off the injured list to pinch hit. One out later, Logan Valencia legs out the infield hit, putting Dallas Williams at second. Down by four, the Sun Devils have the potential tying run on deck, but they are down to their last out. Does this end it? The high pop-up into swirling wind gusts. It drops in just over the infield. Dallas Williams scores from second, Logan Valencia to third. Tanner Fuller on first, and the potential tying run coming to the plate. On a 3-2 pitch, Joey Vera laces the sharp single to left. Logan Valencia scores. Pinch runner Trevor Standridge at third. Apple Valley down by two. Joey Vera represents the tying run at first. Sophomore pinch hitter Derek Rios, the batter. Ramon Alcantar with the strikeout and the victory. Victor Valley upends Apple Valley and eliminates the Sun Devils. The final 5-3.
CIF Baseball Flashbacks to this date in High Desert sports history are brought to you by We Got 'Em Tees, where Letterman Jacket blowout pricing starts at $199 while supplies last. We Got 'Em Tees, your headquarters for custom screen printing and mastercraft embroidery designs. We Got 'Em, official CIF sanctioned Chanel patches for varsity jackets. We Got 'Em Tees, two locations, Apple Valley and Upland. Oh yeah, We Got 'Em Tees.
Your High Desert Sports Report is brought to you by Down Home Grill in Victorville on the corner of Bear Valley Road and Ridgecrest Road. Bid fast and last sold on supporting High Desert Sports. The Bradco Companies, supporting all of the teams and sports programs throughout the Mojave River Valley. Iwanzak Law Firm, trial lawyers for serious problems. Valu Quality Truck Body. Valu manufactures state-of-the-art truck bodies for the construction industry nationwide. We Got 'Em Tees, your headquarters for custom screen printing and mastercraft embroidery design. And by the Holiday Inn in Victorville.
The Holiday Inn, conference and convention center for the High Desert. The Holiday Inn, supporting the teams, schools, and sports programs throughout the Victor Valley.
Terry Kurtz here, inviting you to join us on Terry Kurtz Online, the half-hour report on High Desert and Mojave River Valley events and activities, entertainment, and history. It shows three times daily at 7:30 and 11:30 mornings and 4:30 in the afternoon, right here on Victor Valley TV, immediately following your High Desert Sports Report. It's the most informative and entertaining half-hour of High Desert television today.
The San Bernardino County Fair opens Saturday, May 25th.
Come on out, join us!
This flashback to the 2006
4-H and FFA youngsters at the Junior Livestock Auction.
We work so hard all year round with our animals, and we are tomorrow's leaders. We are the ones that are going to be supporting our nation and our current and our world, basically.
As 4-H'ers and FFA'ers, we work really hard with our animals, and the auction helps us to show the community what we've been doing.
It helps us with our next project, and to learn more about that project, it helps our college funds.
We are the future of California's agriculture. We are the fourth leading economic power in the world.
What's most challenging?
Probably the fitting and clipping of the animal.
The most fun part is working your animal and having a good bond with it. They teach us so many different things, like responsibility.
Some students pour up to $3,000 into their steer project. This year's Junior Livestock Auction is Saturday, June 1st. The 2024 San Bernardino County Fair opens Saturday, May 25th, Memorial Day weekend. All pre-sale unlimited wristbands must be purchased online by Friday, May 24th. Motorsports takes center stage opening weekend. Monster Trucks on Saturday, the Demolition Derby Sunday. We flash back to San Bernardino County Fair events and activities years past.
From carnival rides to bull rides, some drive classic cars, some drive cattle, while still others drive to collide.
Wild and woolly, Wild West, gunfighter shootouts three times daily, rock concerts, tribute bands, carnival rides, fair food, and displays and exhibits await fairgoers.
Prior to the ribbon-cutting formal opening of the 2013 San Bernardino County Fair, school children are treated to a field trip, a guided tour, bringing them up close and sometimes personal with animals domestic, a tiger exotic, creatures, many of them the likes which these youngsters had never before seen, as well as championship livestock, and on to crowd-pleasing entertainers and circus performers. Entries in baked goods and arts and crafts competition, the subject of this report.
Is there one criteria that stands out among others when you judge baked goods?
Yeah. You're looking for what would be your top of the line thing. Now, this cupcake was decorated really pretty with the cupcake and everything, but it was very heavy, very dense. Cupcake is supposed to be light and fluffy.
Like a good cake.
Yeah, like a good cake. Now, this is light and fluffy, but it's not pleasing to the eye. It doesn't have anything that would make you want to try it if it was sitting by itself. This one does, and it's also light and fluffy. It has an extra thing in the center that makes it, you don't know that when you cut into it. And then it has a little strawberry on top. So it's indicating that it's a strawberry cake. I didn't get a strawberry icing taste. Did you bring the icing?
No, but I got it out of
the cake. Yeah, the cake. And the inside is pleasant.
It carried through, yes.
Yeah, everything
here worked together.
So, cosmetic to the eye, because a lot of people, we eat with our eyes. Yeah.
Well, what are the criteria for judging baked goods?
Well, of course it should taste good, but it should be baked well. The flavors should be balanced. It should look, it's not just taste, it's also showmanship in a contest like this. You want a quick bread, which is raised with chemical leavening only, to look pretty. It should rise right. Yeast breads should be fully risen. They shouldn't be a yeast bread should be a bread, not a cake, unless you're actually entering a yeast cake. But it should taste good. It should be well cooked, not over brown. I don't know. I mean, there's other guidelines, but you bake for a while and you pick up things. All it's practice. Practice makes perfect. That's the best thing I could say.
Is there a great variation between the best and the others, or is it really tough to narrow it down to the best?
That varies from year to year.
Okay.
And like, if one year there's a lot of people don't show, you can never tell. I've had things where I've had to judge. I did a cookie thing at a fair once, and I probably judged, I want to remember, between 50 and 100 cookies. That's a big turnout. But sometimes you could have something absolutely fantastic that is absolutely wonderful, and you might have just two people in the category, and that might win best of show. You never know. It varies, but there can be a big difference. You'll get brand new people with people who have been baking for a while. And the longer you bake, the more things you pick up. With the advent of the internet, there's a lot of education out there that you can self-teach yourself. And of course, there's cookbooks at the library. I mean, cookbooks, you buy used cookbooks and read through those and things like that.
How would you compare the San Bernardino County Fair, and this year Get Your Kicks at Route 66, how would you compare judging this fair compared to others?
I like the San Bernardino County Fair. It's a smaller fair. It's what I call a fair fair, where you have quite a few people doing all sorts of crafts, cooking, canned goods, all sorts of things, and it's a real component of the fair that is publicized. Sometimes you go to a fair and it's just, they're not pushing, they're pushing everything else but what to me says it's a county fair. That's the home arts, the quilting, the collections, the foods, the preserved goods, the baked goods, all that stuff, and they push that here, and I really like seeing it. If I go to the fair, I want to go see that stuff. I used to compete, and I like seeing other people compete, and anything in here, it takes a lot of love and a lot of concern and a lot of pride to go and enter it, because you can always not place, and you go, what did I do? But then you go and try it again next year. So,
but a passion also to judge.
Passion,
to,
yes.
But on your part, to judge it.
I'm trying to lose weight. I don't eat everything I taste. I do taste everything.
Yeah.
But I really like seeing all the new stuff. I like variations on stuff. I always thought one of my favorite, a great contest to do would be to say, hey, here, everyone, here's a cookie recipe. And maybe 30 people might bring back these chocolate chip cookies. You got to use this recipe. I bet you every one of them would be different. I mean, it's just, it's interesting, because sometimes you do a little tweak on something. I know with cookies, it could be just a small tweak of temperature of your butter or shortening. It makes a difference between a really good chocolate chip cookie or one that stands up versus one that spreads out and flattens out. Mm-hmm. It's all chewy and gooey. It's just, I like small fairs.
Mm-hmm.
Smaller fairs. I'm not saying this is small, but I think they feel more personable. My favorite fair of all time was a long time ago. I went to one in Huntsville, Alabama. Teeny tiny fair. They had mule races. You could, in between the races, you could go into the infield, but I always remember canned goods. They put jellies up in a window. It was like looking at a stained glass window.
Right.
It was absolutely beautiful.
All right. Okay. Well, thank you. Yeah, thank you for these comments.
Eight battered beaters squared off in the finals of the Destruction Derby. Still in the running, some barely running, for the $2,000 in first place prize money. The Tough Stock Rodeo drew others competing on barebacks, saddlebacks, and bulls in the new rodeo arena. There was a lot for cowboys and cowgirls. The annual cattle drive. Over 100 head of cattle were driven by wranglers, cowhands, and cowgirls alike. This cutting and herding taking place at Las Flores Ranch. Why saddle up?
Oh, the chasing the cows, riding my horse.
I think it's a camaraderie of all the things going on with all the people.
We get to push cattle around. We get to come down Route 66 and see all the kids and the families.
Graham Brothers put on a nice show.
Over 200 classic and custom cars wound their way through the fairgrounds opening weekend. Turns out tigers and turkeys were among the popular crowd favorites. 10 days of very pleasant mid-May weather contributed heavily to the high degree of success of the 2006 San Bernardino County Fair in Victorville.
The Victor Valley's biggest social and entertainment calendar event of the year beckons earlier this spring. Ribbon cutting for the San Bernardino County Fair, May 11th. It's the diamond anniversary of the 28th Agricultural District of California, celebrating the achievements of Area 4-H and FFA youngsters and showcasing competition from residents throughout the largest geographical county in the contiguous United States. This year's fair theme, Memories Are Forever. As nostalgia prevails, one headliner group excels in reviving the swing era. In the process, the spotlight shines on the local group achieving national recognition with their big band sound, Fat Cat Swinger. We'll see clowns and classic cars parading the first Saturday of the fair. One of the truly unique activities of the 28th Agricultural District's agenda is the opportunity to saddle up and become a cowhand in an honest-to-goodness Old West cattle drive. This has become a trademark event exclusive to the San Bernardino County Fair. Local performers add their talents to the non-stop entertainment throughout the fairgrounds. One finds music of every genre, from musicians in authentic attire performing the songs of over 100 years ago to acts reviving hits of the more recent past. The carnival alone attracts its throng of fairgoers, the expected array of exhibits and displays providing the chance to see the work of our neighbors in a seemingly unending variety of categories and divisions. The Junior Livestock Auction is the second Saturday of this 10-day event. May 11th through the 20th, memories live forever at this year's San Bernardino County Fair in Victorville. It's madness! You can see it in their faces. From human pyramids to hula hoop races. Dancing? Gladly! Mascot dancing? Madly! Tomorrow the muscles will be sore after the spirited tug of war. Unique factors in force, a tropical obstacle course. In this table manners matchup, food disappears fast in the furious finale. Now that's a mouthful. The event that's last. All in the spirit of energetic competition and bragging rights for the High School Madness Travel and Trophy. It's High School Madness added to the hilariously entertaining activities at the San Bernardino County Fair. The County Fair Junior Livestock Leaders host the competition, stage the event, and get the program started demonstrating the proper mechanics of the human pyramid. The competition begins, and the suspense mounts. The madness piles up. This is a test of coordination, stamina, endurance, and balance. Criteria for success in the traditional tug-of-war, teamwork, and strength. We're only as strong as our weakest link. There's the hula hoop race. No need to explain. Who finishes first, more team points to claim. And for the one team member who is a real swinger, the Tropical Orange Obstacle Course race. Now, which team's got the ringer? Which dueling dancers bust the best moves? The cool cougar mascot, he's in the groove. Teams are comprised of 6 members, 3 gals, and 3 guys, and 1 adult representative who is fast food wise. This grand finale is this tough to swallow, make food disappear amid all the holler. When points are all tallied and all's said and done, Granite Hills wins in the spirit of fun. High School Madness, competition for our teams. Returning to your San Bernardino County Fair in 2014.
Terry Kurtz here, inviting you to join us on Terry Kurtz Online, the half-hour report on High Desert and Mojave River Valley events and activities, entertainment and history. It shows 3 times daily at 7:30 and 11:30 mornings and 4:30 in the afternoon, right here on Victor Valley TV, immediately following your High Desert Sports Report. It's the most informative and entertaining half-hour of High Desert television today.
Your High Desert Sports Report is brought to you by Down Home Grill in Victorville on the corner of Bear Valley Road and Ridgecrest Road.
Bid fast and last, sold on supporting High Desert Sports, the Bronco companies supporting all of the teams and sports programs throughout the Mojave River Valley. Iwanzak Law Firm, trial lawyers for serious problems. Valu Quality Truck Body. Valu manufactures state-of-the-art truck bodies for the construction industry nationwide. We got 'em tees. Your headquarters for custom screen printing and mastercraft embroidery design. And by the Holiday Inn in Victorville. The Holiday Inn, conference and convention center for the High Desert. The Holiday Inn, supporting the teams, schools, and sports programs throughout the Victor Valley.
That's a wrap on this week's edition of your High Desert Sports Report. Thank you for joining us.